ready for tonight?
Yeah, man. Got some good shit here, man.
Hey, beer for Simon! Hey, no way! You gotta be first in the back seat, mate!
How you doing, girls?
Come on, then, get in. No, you're in the middle, I get past it.
What the fuck are you doing, man?
I've got to digest my dinner, man. Leave me alone.
Yeah, you're all laughing now, but you'll be wanting something from me as soon as this car stops.
No, yeah, what you got?
Don't you worry about me, mate. Just hope this piece of shit gets signaled tonight.
Hey, what the fuck are you doing? I'm not listening to fucking England lose again and watching fucking English fans getting deported again.
Yes, Mark.
Are they ever gonna stop playing this tune?
Yeah, hopefully just when you start to like it.
Struggling to pay the rent, but Mum's still got a smile on her face.
Sounds weird.
Yeah,
why aren't you carrying for me tonight?
Are you sure?
You don't need to, man. I already know you've got one spare.
I'll carry this for me.
You sure?
Yeah, man.
Yeah,
you're a good man, you know that?
Look, the two of you have pussyfooted around each other for so long. If you don't give it a go now, you're never gonna know.
I hate you.
Yeah, I love you too, honey.
Fuck.
Look, I'm not saying go back in there and start to straddle him. He's probably wired and really sweaty, and to be honest, I find him a bit annoying. But all I'm trying to say is, if you just stop being a bitch for 1 second, then he could surprise you.
Stop saying
shit. Oh, you're welcome. Drink.
Your hands.
Sorry if I'm interrupting anything.
No. Tried to stay away from the stuff, but it helps.
You have heard of coffee though, right? does the same thing.
Not really my thing. Don't like the taste. Would you like some?
Coffee?
No, speed.
Oh, no, thanks. It's not really my thing.
So what do you want then?
Obviously I stick out as much as I thought. Well, Mark, I'm a journalist. And I'm really interested in the emerging scene you kids are involved in. I just wanted to ask some questions.
Kids? We're adults. We're the oppressed youth.
Youths, then?
Ask me a question then, Cronkite.
I'm a journalist, not a reporter.
But if you've not got any actual questions, I get to...
Is this a job for you? This is how you choose to gain your income?
I don't do this because of job stability. I do this because I love music. What you don't understand is... all these strikes, all these crackdowns, all this disparity isn't out of necessity, it's out of spite, revenge and power. I can't get a real job because I'm uneducated.
Why didn't you stay in education?
Because my father lost his mining job and we had to move down here to live. So what even is this? I'm not interested in a therapy session being published for whatever tabloid you write for.
Sorry, you just look so relaxed, I thought you'd been interviewed before.
No! Because people don't care about what we're doing or why we're doing it. They're only interested when there's a bust in Manchester and 20 unemployed youths get knocked up.
Well, what is this about then?
We're having a party! What do you like to do for fun? We like to do this.
What are we celebrating?
We're celebrating being able to listen to the music we love on our own terms.
Well, what are they? Look, I'm not here to accuse you. I can't even quote you if you tell me not to. You've caught my interest. I just walked in on you doing speed. Can you not see why people would think this is just a big fuck you?
I don't talk about this in Parliament. I don't talk about this in your newspaper. I did a rave a few weeks ago, identical to this, in a place across town. Got raided, people got arrested. My mate's in jail now because of it on bullshit grounds. You know what they found when they searched the whole place? Cans of Coke, bottles of water, energy drinks, no drugs, no booze, no races, no religions. It's the night of music. You know, he's making a name for itself. Yeah. The reality is, people maybe try it once, twice. But what they come back for is that. Music. You know, this isn't like football, which everyone loves. We are one team playing together. We're not out of control. We're organised with a purpose and we're having fun with a big risk. Not tonight, we take drugs. But Monday's a brand new day. We all go back to our normal lives. But we all remember what this liberation felt like. It's not political at all. We're just having a party. You're right.
Just wondering if you'd seen Si?
No, not for a little bit. I've got to go back on now, but I'll have a look.
Who are you supposed to be then?
Oh, sorry. I'm Rebecca.
Beth.
So, if you don't mind me asking, what's your part in all of this?
Just another cog in the system, dear.
Right.
Kim! What the hell are you doing? There's no place for you!
How can you say that to me, Lee?
Not blaming me, man. You need to go!
What on earth are you talking about? That never actually happened.
Yeah, don't come down here asking to learn stuff and then refute what I tell you.
I'm staying and I'm having fun with my friends.
I don't have to say anything to your privileged little ponytail.
Look, calm down.
Don't tell me to calm down, you vulture!
Hey, get in.
I think my friends should be following
me. You think? No, that's not good enough. Come on!
Say, come with me.
Right now! Right now!
Oh my God, have you guys seen this?
Stopping Thatcher. What's this about, me?
Just read it.
In the aftermath of the momentous resignation of the Prime Minister, the people of Great Britain have been singing in the streets. Yeah, she's a fucking bitch.
A step down to knock any chance of a Heseltine rise to power got me to think of what I had seen aid the toppling of the Iron Lady. The miners failed to get their voice heard, but the youths of England spoke louder and more concisely than we could ever have imagined. So,
look who wrote it.
No, fucking hell. Fuck. Football fans will still lose their terraces, but the growing underground party scene will not only remain, but be able to grow
their home. Lost and without purpose they are not. Violent drug addicts couldn't be a more foreign concept. Nihilistic youths, as they have been described, is just wrong. Getting to see firsthand what this movement is all about changed my outlook permanently. Soon the dogs and the flashing blue lights will come to tear down this unifying night. But the rave teaches an important lesson to overassuming adults. Being content is not to be satisfied. These young adults have decided on, built, and fought for their own world of joy in their own right. These driving forces are the people you see every day. The nurse who dressed your wound, the teaching assistant at your child's school, the cab driver hauling you between meetings. They are the prominent voice of the newly influential generation, and we are better for it with them deciding our new path as a country. One day, they will move out of their warehouses and fields and into homes next to you, and you'll adore their spirit and their candour. But for now, this journey teaches them acceptance and unity that this country so desperately needs, now more than ever.